somebody throws cancer into your sphere, it's pretty jarring. So the news was kind of immediately quite devastating too. It was so far away from anything I would have expected it being, that massive shock. My name's Quinn Johnsen. I'm 34 years old. I'm an industrial designer in Toronto. Enjoy traveling with my wife and kind of new restaurants, enjoying the city to pretty normal, easygoing stuff. I initially was just kind of feeling off, was kind of more exhausted than I felt like was reasonable or normal. So went to Toronto Western and they pretty quickly determined that something more serious was off. I had a gastroscopy initially to kind of get a look from the inside out as to what was going on. They went to get a biopsy and get some further information. That definitely led to the cancer diagnosis. I checked into the hospital in early January, and I don't think it was until mid-late February that my diagnosis was finalized. I was kind of in and out of the hospital quite frequently, like managing my well-being while they were digging deeper into what the cause of it was. We got the biopsy results back and it turned out to be synovial sarcoma. I'd be going through trimodal therapy, so chemo was kind of the next immediate step from there. I had only made it through 4 of the 6 cycles of chemo that I was originally intended to go through. The chemo on the 4th cycle punctured my stomach and left me hospitalized for, I think it was 2.5 months. Couldn't ingest anything for those 2 months. So I was fed intravenously and I had no immune system. So was not really able to see people. So in that facet of it was so dramatic, and we were working towards surgery at that time. Treatment really immediately took over my life. Like, it wasn't something that was gonna be balanced with a normal life. At that point in time, I was not able to work due to the frequency and my dependency on being in and out of the hospital. Physically, it of course got more challenging as things went on, but I was lucky in the sense of I handled the treatment quite well. It was incredibly effective. I think that it had reduced the initial tumor by about 70%. Mentally, it was really challenging, but you know, having Kate and my family being so supportive through it all, really just kind of ready to take on whatever the course of action with treatment was gonna be, because it was apparent of how much of a necessity it was. I had 2 years of no evidence of disease in between surgery, and then at just a routine follow-up scan, they had identified something in my lower pelvic region that was concerning, and they biopsied it, and it was the same synovial sarcoma. That was kind of when the afami-cel treatment was brought up.
Afami-cel is a form of therapy that is classed under cell therapy. Basically, we're trying to harness the patient's own immune system, but re-engineered to recognize certain proteins or antennas on the tumor so that we can direct those to attack the tumors within the patient, him or herself.
My cancers responded really well thus far. So I initially was having a CT scan every month after receiving the cells, and the 5 days in hospital went as well as you could hope. The side effects were really limited. For the first 3 scans, I had 15% reduction approximately on each of those scans. And as of my last scan, I'm up to a 63% reduction. Been more the narrative the last couple months. Treatment has really not impacted my ability to work, do the things I enjoy. And my life has kind of returned to as normal as possible from the afami-cel treatment. So I'm just incredibly grateful for the success and effectiveness of that. This research has become so personalized. You're not treated with a blunt instrument in a sense, which is what chemo can be at times, where it's just chasing any rapidly producing cells in your system. And the afami-cel treatment is so much more targeted to exactly the cells that are spreading and causing problems and continuing to attack different parts of your body. The importance of it to me is second to none, really. And I have a huge amount of respect and appreciation for the research that goes into this and the constant development of these personalized and targeted treatments.